Hi, my name is Ginger Cook, and if you're new to my channel, I'm an acrylic artist and I teach fine art painting and techniques on this channel. And normally we do a live class on Monday nights at 7:30 Central Time and Tuesdays and Wednesdays. This particular week in December, or January rather, John and I are off on a vacation for the week. And so what we're putting up today is a video I thought you might find interesting. I've entitled it, Can Your Brush Do That? Not can you do that with your brush, but can your brush do that? And the reason I say that is that sometimes you'll see an artist on YouTube and they'll be doing something tricky and you do it and you can't do it and you think it's you, and very possibly it's your brush. Now, not always, but it can be. So we're going to just focus a little bit on some brushes that you might want to own, because really having a good brush makes all the difference in the world, and keeping it nice because they wear out. So that can be some things that you want to do. So we're going to go through a few little things, just some stuff I think you might find helpful about brushes. Now, if you focus down here on my table for a minute, you'll see I've got a group of brushes out here, different ones, mostly the Ruby Satin Silvers. And the reason I like this brand, I've been using it for years, is because as an acrylic artist, I like bright brushes. Now, oil painters often prefer what's called a filbert, which is more rounded, okay? And someone often asks the question, can I use oil painting brushes and into my acrylics? If you're doing both mediums, have a different set. I wouldn't cross over with oil paints and acrylic brushes. Just, I wish, wouldn't do it. But in any event, a lot of times the oil painting brushes are a little stiffer, a little more bristle, war's hair bristle, kind of stiffer, a little scratchy, maybe get more scratches in it. The mediums are so different, they require it. Really, acrylic paints require a synthetic brush, they really do, and a fairly stiff one. You'll see this, that has to have a little spring in it. I don't know how anybody would order brushes over the internet and not know what they were buying, because I like to go to the art store and just go around and go spring, see what it does. And sometimes too, there's sizing on the brushes at the art store, almost like a glue kind of, you know, so they look all pointy and stiff when you get them home and you rinse that stuff off, and they're not that at all. So that's something to keep in mind too. Now, my favorite ones are, for instance, these Ruby Satin Silvers. This is a long handle number 12. People have asked me the difference between a long handle and a short handle. Sometimes, you know, the short handles they don't come in bigger sizes. They pretty much stop at about this size, maybe one up from that. And they're fine. And if you have kids painting, I would sure buy short handle brushes for your kids. But, you know, basically, if I'm up close, I'm holding the brush. If you look at the screen here, down here at the table, I'm holding the brush. I'm holding it on the right by the metal part. And I have it rested on this thumb, and this finger is loose. I often see people have this finger so tight, this wrist is tight, and then they can't get the brush to do anything because their hand is like a knot. You've got to relax the hand, rest the brush on the middle finger, have this finger kind of loose and just there as a brace. And if you can, try to paint from your shoulder, not from your wrist. Now, in instances when you are painting like this with your hand, if you can rest your little finger here as a brace and then try it. So those are just some tips on how to hold the brush. Left-handed people, you know, I'm going to bring in a left-handed artist to talk about this, because I really can't tell you. You're different, but in any event, you want to be loose. And one way you can practice that is practice just taking a pencil and a paper and drawing circles like this over and over and over again from your shoulder, rows of those. That will really help you get the habit of drawing from your shoulder. So one thing is that fine lines are what really do people in. I've got a few videos here on YouTube on fine lines. I don't think we can talk about this enough. You get over 100 videos, some of these get kind of lost. People have no idea anymore where to find this stuff. There's different types of paint in acrylics. There's something called flow. And I'll put a little of this out to see if that's going to flow a little bit. Matisse makes a flow, fluid paints by Gold and so forth, a little bit more fluidy. And then you have something called heavy body. Now, they act differently. So a heavy body paint is thicker, okay? You think about peanut butter, it's thicker, all right? So if you're trying to do a very, very fine, thin line with a thicker paint like this, and you've got a little pointy brush like that, I'm not saying you can't do it. One of the first things, if you, I'm going to just zoom in. I think it's zooming in is this. Yeah. Ha, I've got my own zoomer now. All right. So you see how close I am, right? Ooh, I'm going to back it out just a hair like this. Now, really close. Now, one of the things you do is you roll the brush, put it in there, and roll the excess paint off, all right? Start with that, climb it up. Now, if I want to do a fine line and you're not sure where, start, put a dot here and maybe a dot here. Have a sense of where you're going, all right? So now I'm going to just pull it. Now, my hand's staying still. Now, what's happening? I'm moving my whole arm to get it up here like that. Now, I didn't get a very good line, did I? Well, because one, I didn't wet the brush. So let's just go back over here. Let me just zoom back out a minute here, and I'll go back over here to show you this little tiny bit of water. This is, then I'm gonna wipe it off like that, roll it off on a rag like that. Now I'm gonna come back over here. I'm gonna zoom back in, and I'll show you again here. Same thing. Here, I'm gonna push just like this. Now I want you to see the difference when you have a little bit of water on your brush. It'll make a difference. You're still not getting a great flow. Now, is it the brush? This is a round brush. Round brushes are usually pretty good for thin lines. Let's try a tiny bit of water on the tip of the brush, a little bit back over here. Let's try it one more time, okay? So do I have enough water? Sometimes that'll make a difference. If you have enough water where it isn't too runny, your brush is just kind of loose, that will help. The other thing that will help you, and then I always have a big bucket of water to change colors with, all right? I have a little tiny something like that, little heart thing, for just a little dab of water. Now I'm going to come over here to my fluid paint, and I want you to see that. Here it is, same brush, like that. Now look how much easier the fluid paint does, the flow. So sometimes, and people say, well, I can't just buy everything at the art store. Listen, buy browns and whites, and maybe even your dark browns and your whites, and maybe even a light beige or something, in the fluids, because in the flows, because one, you can use them to sign your name, and two, tree branches and stuff. This happens to be a gray that I had for another project, but you can see how much better the flow works than just the heavy body paint. So even though most of the time, like a painting like this, this is all done with a palette knife and heavy body, but if you can do if you can use a flow for your smaller stuff, that's really good. I can't say that enough, it's important. Now that was just how that brush might work. Now what if, let's just take this a minute. So you're bopping along here, I'm gonna do another one here, bopping along here like this, and I've got this, and I push too hard, because the harder you push, you've got a fatter, it's fatter. Now I want to erase that. It's too fat and I'm unhappy and I think I've ruined my painting. Well, one thing you should always, if you're worried about something like that, get in the habit of drawing your picture before you do the next step. And then you can take a brush like this. This is, let me just show you here, I've got some rolled under. These are ruby satin silvers. And this is our angle brush, quarter inch angle brush. And I'm gonna wet it and wipe it off, and I'm going to come under here like this. Now watch it. I'm going to erase. I'm going to go back and forth like this, and I'm going to sneak up in here, and I'm going to erase. And I'm going to go back over here to the water so you can see just a minute. And this is called rinse, wipe, swipe. So you wipe off the brush, then come back. You only get a little tiny bit. Rinse, wipe, swipe. It's like mopping a floor. But now, if you don't have a stiff brush, it won't erase. So the question is, can your brush do this? Maybe it can, maybe it can't. You should be able to do this. See how this is just erasing it? Making the line thinner, and I'll zoom in on that a little bit here and let you see what I'm talking about. Let's just do one more thin erase. I mean, you literally can take it like this. Now, we don't have any kind of painting on this canvas. We're just right on top of the gesso, but you can see how thin I can get this line, rinse, wipe, swipe, and you don't get two wipes, or you don't get a wipe and a rinse. You have to rinse it each time, otherwise you're going to be dragging color. But that's how you get that's one way to get a thin line. Another way to get a thin line is to make a fat line and then take another line next to it, like that. Just paint another line of color next to it, the color that was meant to be next to it. Now this line is thin because you've kind of painted over the part you didn't want. So there's a couple of ways you can get a thin line, but I want to just show you this. I'm in this ruby satin silver brush. The thing about an angle brush is that you not only can do a nice wide line like this, you see, but you can take it on its knife edge. Now look here. Look at that. Now that's that heavy. That's that heavy body paint. And look at the thin line I got. And I'm going to rinse it. And then one thing you can do is you can pinch it to a point. Pinch it. Get in the habit of pinching your brush, squeezing it. Then come back over here in the paint. You zoom out just a hair so you can see what I just did. Come back over here in the paint, just like that, both sides. All right, don't dive in like it's a swimming pool. Now start here and barely touch it. If you just look at how tiny I can get on, if I push hard, it goes fat, barely touch it. Now, if when you pinch it to a point, it's no longer going to a point anymore, you may have worn out a little of this brush, and that's okay. They brushes wear out if you use them all the time, and also particularly on rough canvas, which is why I recommend sanding a lot of your canvases. And I'm going to show you another smaller one, ruby satin silver, smaller one. This is the 3/8 inch one, and this is really tiny. I'm going to show you this. I'm going to rinse it, I'm going to wet it, and come back over here in the flow. Let's just try the flow. Now the same thing. I'm going to come up here like this. Harder I push, the fatter the line. Now what's happened with this one, even though I love these angles, is that I have used this brush so much, it's time to order a new one. If you cannot do a thin line anymore, then it's time to get in it. Did it in the beginning, it's time to order another brush. And just there is a life to these brushes. Now, one way you can save your brushes, I'm going to say that to you, look up here and smile and say that, is to wash them with a good brush soap, good brush cleaner, and then get all the paint out of them and then dry them flat and on a paper towel. Make sure you've rinsed the extra water out of them and squeezed the water out and then dry them flat. And don't let them sit around in water for a couple of days before you get around to doing that, okay? That's really important. Okay, so I'm going to show you, now we were kind of impressed with these thin lines. I'm going to show you, this is the number 12 bright brush. I'm going to wet it and I'm going to pinch it to a point like that. Now I'm going to come right back into this flow. Now look how big this brush is. Now I want you to see this. Look at the line I can get. Look at the thin line I can get. Yes, I can get a line like that. I can get a big wide one. But I think it's very impressive, and sometimes you just want the tips. A very good bright brush will give you an angle like this. You can just barely touch it and get a little tiny thin line. So sometimes when you're painting along and you're painting like this, and then you can lift it up and then get it on its edge like this, and then do this, just kind of twist it. See? All right. Your brushes should be able to do that. If they can't, I'm going to suggest, now somebody says, well, where do you get these? Well, you know, all major art stores have been carrying ruby satin silvers forever, Dick Blick and Jerry's and all that stuff. But the source that we've made available for our members of our gingercooklive.gallery and also our YouTube friends is a source that we really have liked. These guys are called the Brush Guys. They originally worked for a big paint company and decided they would specialize in brushes, and they carry just so many different brands of brushes called the Brush Guys. And they were very kind. They gave me an artist page, and anytime I find a brush I like, they list it on their page with the price. If you put in your title, you know, in the discount code Ginger Cook in the code, they give you an extra 5%. They ship all over the world. This was real important to me. If you're in Sweden or in Australia or someplace and you want this brush and you can't get it in your own hometown, they will mail it to you, obviously, you know, and they have a price up there. It's not a big surprise about what it's going to be. It's just out of the country, this is so much, and this is what it's going to cost, and that 5% I think will make a difference. And so anytime I can get you guys a deal, I try to, all right? Now, another brush that I want to talk to you about, we can come back down to the table, is that these are called liner brushes. So sometimes, you see these a lot in watercolor, and sometimes I'm going to wet it, and sometimes what a liner brush does is that it really literally is for lines, okay? So look at this. Can you see me crossing over here with the lines? Look at that. And it easily carries the lines. I mean, is this not cool or what? Look at that. See how it's crossing over the lines like that? So if you, and I'm holding it, now interestingly, I'm holding it way out here at the edge as opposed to up here on here. I'm holding it way out at the very edge of the brush. Now here it goes, look at that. And if I push hard, it goes thinner, look at that. If for however they've done it, the paint flows nicely, just wants to flow. And I'm just using, again, I'm using more of the liquid paint, but still, this is a great brush. It's almost as, look at that. I mean, could you, so what I would tell you to do is if your brush can't do this, get one that can. Now there's a different brands of liners. Just mentioned that two different brands of liners, and here's a, see, I had a, everything's hiding under here. Here we go, they're rolling under my stuff. Here's a ruby satin silver liner, which is an extremely nice one. Let me just try that for you. Here we go, so it's gonna roll off the tip here. Here's our liner now. Holds a lot of paint, look at that. Holds a lot of paint. So that's a brush that you need, okay? A liner brush is one that you absolutely need in your portfolio of brushes. I mean, I'm just saying that that's pretty neat, isn't it? All right. I mean, you can see what I'm doing with that. So if you don't have a brush that does that, now let's see what it does with a heavy body. I'm just going to, you have to put a little more water with it, with your paint when you're doing that. Okay. You can even use some flow medium, but here we go. Here's the red. Now look, it does a thicker, thinner, like that. You can just twirl. And what you might want to do is next time you're, you know, sitting around watching a movie on the computer or television, grab your brushes and just play with them. Do a little brush exercise. See if you can make some thick and thin lines. Play with it. I mean, come around like this, play with your brushes. Look at that, see? I mean, you should be able to, the big question is, can your brush do that? That's the big question. That's what you want to answer. Now, the last brush I'm going to show you is that there's a little section. We've have found that there's a little package of nail brushes. People are painting all kinds of things on their fingernails these days and tiny, intricate designs. And the nail salons have stepped up to that, and they're doing real art on people's fingernails. I love it. And so they've made these brushes that were really designed for enamel nail polish, okay? And they're very tiny, and they're cheap. Man, these are, I want to say these are cheap, okay? And did I say that? They're cheap, okay? And I think the price, I'm trying to think what we talked about, but it was under $10 for a bunch of them, wasn't it, John? Yes. And so we have those listed on our website as well. And I'm just going to show you that they don't, all right, they're not designed for acrylics, all right, first off, and they don't hold the load of paint like a ruby satin silver will. They don't hold as much paint in the bristles, okay? But I'm just going to show you this little brush here. Here's a little tiny one. But it does make, look at that, it does make a little tiny line. Now I start to lose the line at some point. Water on just the tip of the brush. Let's try it again. But for some kind of difficult, for some difficult, you know, fine art, you know, sometimes you need, and here's an example of a painting that I offered recently for our Wave and Water Masterclass, and there's some tiny little bits on the picture that need, you know, that you might want a small brush, all right? So you might come along here like this and just very carefully do a tiny line, and sometimes, I mean, you can also buy, by the way, you guys, you can buy something called acrylic inks that are really good. I mean, I'm not trying to have, you know, I don't own these art stores. I'm just saying that, again, the colors you think you might use the most, white, black, brown, you know, red, things that you think you might want, acrylic, little bottles of acrylic ink, and that really flows well too, okay? So that's an example of something that you might want to be, have a tiny brush. This is a really, another one that, let me just zoom back out on here. Like this. Let me just get this out of the way. This horse, this draft horse, is one of the lessons on gingercooklive.gallery. And I want you to just, if I zoom in, can you see the, can you see these little chains here and some of these little light, these tiny little brush marks? That takes a small brush, okay? This brush, this action, this blending action, is different, but when you're talking about some cases, you need a detail brush, a good detail brush, and they're worth having. And so I have a whole set of these little funny ones and these little tiny Chinese ones too. And when they wear out, I just throw them away because, you know, $10 for, you know, a pile of them. Here was another little tiny one that they had, and that you know out of a whole set, I'm not saying I like all of them. Here was one. Here's this little kind of bright brush, and I'm going to show you. It's okay, but it's not. Again, it doesn't hold the paint, but it might be okay. And listen, if you're, I mean, you can see what I'm doing. It's doing something, right? So again, the question you have to ask is, can my brush do that? That's what you're going to ask, the question you're going to ask. Here's another example of some paintings that were, that I think where you might want to have a detailed brush. For instance, this pansy basket, another lesson on our website, where you have to start shading and, you know, creating this small, these small details, or perhaps even here with the pansies where you've got these little tiny lines coming out. That can be very nice. Now, mostly I painted this with a bright brush, but when you get down to the detail, you need a finer art brush. Just last week we painted this large pansy picture. Let me zoom back out on this. Zoomy out. Okay. Now, you see, this one was all done with a large bright brush. This was about 90% of this picture was done with a brush like this. Truly, I just did it with this brush. This whole painting, I was very little. I think I signed my name with a tiny brush. I didn't really use a small brush on this. So again, it depends what you're painting. That's and the size of the brush. People always say, well, how big a brush should you use? How big a brush? It depends on what you're painting. This large filbert is very nice to a background for a big painting. And I want to just show you real quick what this brush does. Let me just find a different color paint here, and I'm going to show you real quick what this does. I'm going to paint over some of this. The difference between a brush like this and, say, a bright brush is the fact that when you make a mark with it, and while you might want a couple filberts just to have in your pool of brushes, okay, so here's some Southern Ocean Blue, and I'm going to wet it just a bit like that and tap it off, and then I'm going to take a little Southern Ocean Blue. I want to show you this. I'm going to come over here like this. Now, when you lift up, it, because it's rounded, it when you lift up, it's a little softer. Do you see that? Because it's rounded. Now, the bright brush will do, I'll show you this one. The bright brush does more of a hard edge here. Do you see that? Okay, but the filbert, it's a little softer. You see, because you're getting the rounded edges. So sometimes when you're doing a landscape, it looks kind of pretty to paint all over that. Look, you can see my picture coming through there. Isn't that kind of cool? That this is a color called Southern Ocean Blue, and it's interesting. It's more of a translucent color, and you know, it almost acts like a glaze. Isn't that just a little piece of side point there? So those are some things that you want to do now. The other thing you can do with your brush, can your brush do that? If it's stiff enough, you can take, let's see, what have we got? Let's take a little white. I'm going to show you this. These are tricks I've showed you before, but I think this is a good video. Sometimes you just have to get back to the basics. What can my brush do? And I've got some white here. Now, if I go sideways like this with the brush, I can go on the side of this, like that. See what I'm doing? And just titanium white going on the side of that. Now I'm going to wipe the brush off and go on the side of it again. Now I want you to see how I melted this color here. And if I want it, I can do it on the other side too. Just the edges here. I'm going to melt that little light highlight. How do you get a highlight? Can your brush do that? If your brush isn't able to do that, it's not you. It's not you. So let's just tap a little more white in here. Let's just do it one more time. Here, I'm going to just show you that like that. Here, I'm going to show you that like that. I'm going to take a rag and wipe the edges off, extra paint off. I'm going to come up here to the sides, barely touch it like this, barely touch it like that. Soften that out, blend that out, just using the side of the brush like that. There you go. I'm saying your brush should be able to do those things, all right? And if it can't, then consider when your budget allows, upgrading your brush. That's all. That's my thing today. I hope this was helpful. If you like some of those videos of those paintings we showed you, check out our website, gingercooklive.gallery. We have over 500 hours of video lessons. Each one of our lessons is step by step, and it's over. You know, hour, 2 hours, some of them are 5 hours long. I mean, we really get down to the nitty gritty and show you how to paint. This is a good back to basics. Can my brush do that? Listen, likes, comments, happy thoughts are always welcome on our website. Share us with others. Thank you for watching and have a great day.